Name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and it's a privilege for every one of us to come together in the presence of God and to worship the Lord in truth and spirit. And God has given and added one more Sunday in our life to gather together and praise the name of the Lord and to hear the word of God. So once again I welcome everyone, and first of all, I as a senior pastor of Eternal Life Church of God, I would like to wish a happy Father's Day blessings to all the dads in our church. And I pray may God bless you all and strengthen every father of our church in the coming days. Amen. And I believe that all the fathers have already got gifts from your children. Even I got a gift yesterday that is nothing else but a car. A car with a good amount of loan. Amen. Hallelujah. So I thank God for everything, and I pray for every dad of our church, and may God bless every one of us. And I believe this is the time, and this is the right time to maybe the celebrations are the right time to speak something about the portion, maybe the poem that which is related to that celebration. You know, when we celebrate the birthday, or when we celebrate the anniversary, so there is a chance to preach about that thing. You know, so that's what I think and I believe. So this is a good chance to preach to the people of God about the responsibilities of the parents and maybe the father or something. So, and as today is a special day celebration, Father's Day celebration, I would like to preach a message related to the Father's Day, to the Father's Day. This is going to be the visionary parents. The topic of today's message is going to be the visionary parents, not the missionary parents, but it's the visionary parents. And I would like to focus on mainly two points. The first one is a vision of a parent, and secondly, the responsibilities of a parent. The vision of a parent and the responsibilities of a parent. So as we go through this portion, we just want to know one thing, that we have a responsibility, and we should have a vision about our children. Right? Every parent must have a vision, that why we call it as a, that's why we are calling it as a visionary parent. So the parent who is having the vision about his family or about his children and the church and the society and the vision about the future, that man, that parent is called as the visionary parent. So we should have that we should have that vision about our children and their future, and also about our society and our family and all those things. I read one thing from a book. It is like this, and Helen Keller was once asked, what would be worse than being born blind? What would be worse than being born blind? So she replied like this, that to have sight without vision, to have sight without vision is the worse than being born blind. So, and also she said like this, every child who is blessed with a visionary parent has wings. Every child who is blessed with a visionary parent has wings, which means, they have the real understanding about where they are going, and they have the real understanding about what they are going to do, and what is the future of those people or the children. Because if the parent is having the vision about the children, and we understand that, those children will have the wings, and they will have to fly in different ways, and they'll be fruitful for the kingdom of God. So that's the reason I said we should have the vision about our children. Hallelujah. So now we are going to the next heading like this, the spiritual vision of a parent. The spiritual vision of a parent. You know, for example, let us take parents of Moses, Amram, and Jochebed. Okay, so when you read about Moses, the life of Moses, we understand, you know, this is, the parents of Moses is the, best example for the spiritual vision of the parent. They were having a spiritual vision about Moses. His parents were having a spiritual vision about Moses. You know, let us read, Hebrews chapter 11, verse 23. Let us read that, verse from Bible. Hebrews chapter 11, verse 23. There we read about, what was the, what was the speciality of Moses and what the parents could do to Moses when he was born. It is written like this: by faith, Moses, when he was born, was hidden for 3 months by his parents because they saw that the child was beautiful and they were not afraid of the king's command. It says that by faith, Moses, when he was born, he was hidden for 3 months by his parents because they saw that the child was beautiful and they were not afraid of the king's commandment. You know, what we understand from this, it is written that, his parents preserved the baby Moses for 3 months. They preserved or kept, Moses, the child, the baby child, in their own house, for 3 months. So it was not that, it was not that easy to keep or preserve a child inside the house for 3 months. It is very difficult. You know, a small child, keeping the child inside the house is not easy. It's not that easy. You know, the story is in the book of Exodus chapter 2. What is happening there? The story is written, clearly written in Exodus chapter 2. What is that? It tells us how the king of Egypt in his hatred tried to wipe out the children of the Israelites by having them killed at birth. So it was the commandment, it was the order that when the Jewish child is born, you have to kill him. You have to kill him. So that was the order and that was the command of the king of Egypt. The king was determined that hidden children should be sought out and killed. Now when a child hears another child crying, he will also will cry. So Egyptian mothers were sent into the homes of the Israelites with their babies. There they picked their babies until they cried. This made the hidden children of the Israelites to cry too, and so they were discovered and killed. You know, when these people, Israel woman, they carry the baby, and they are coming to their house. And what is happening? So when they hear the children inside the house of the Jewish people, when they hear the sound of the crying of the child baby or somebody, so they also started to cry. So this was what happening in those days. You know, that's the reason that, you know, the parents of Moses, we understand that they were keeping and preserving Moses, in their own house for 3 months. Hallelujah. So let us see what made them to keep him at home for 3 months. What made them to keep him, at home, for 3 months. There are many reasons. You know, there are many reasons. We are going to that portion, you know. When a parent is having a vision about his children, when a parent is having a special vision, insight about the children, they will be doing something in a special way. They'll be doing everything in a special way for that child. You know, let us see what made them to keep or preserve Moses, in their own house for 3 months. 3 months. Answer. We can see in that portion that they were having a clear vision about his child. Okay, they were having, or the parents were having a clear vision about, their child, that he is a special child and going to be used by God to bring the people of Israel from Egypt to Canaan. So we should understand that when we have a vision about our children, or if we are a visionary parent, we should have that conviction that my child is going to be used by God, to be glorifying the name of the Lord. Another important thing is in this passage is they were well aware about the divine beauty of their child. They were well aware about the divine beauty of the baby. Amen. You know, we have to come to that point because they saw he was a proper child. They saw he was a proper child. That means a baby with a divine beauty. You know, when you read Acts chapter 7, verse 20, Acts chapter 7, verse 20, it says that, okay, that child was exceeding fair. The child was exceeding fair. It talks about Moses. In Malayalam, it is written, I think, Moshe, oru divya sundaranayirun. Divya sundaranayirun. Acts chapter 7, verse 20. So that's what we understand. They were having a proper understanding about their child. That said, that a baby with a divine beauty, the beauty which Moses was having, and they understood, they recognized that it's a divine beauty. Hallelujah. So we should see the divine beauty in the face of our children. That is our responsibility. Every parent of our church should see and should watch the divine beauty of our child in their face. Hallelujah. That's what we understand from that portion. Another important thing is they were all well aware about the divine call on Moses. They were well aware about the divine call of Moses. You know, we should realize the call on our children and talents. So we know we have our children, and we should understand what is the call about that child. Okay, maybe about our daughter, maybe about our son. What is the real call of God? Every child of God, has a call from God. So we should understand, recognize what is the real call of God, and what is the talent of that person, what is the talent of the child, and what is the caliber of that child, and how that child can be used for the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. That God is going to, and Moses' parents, they were thinking that God is going to use this boy as a leader for Israel. God is going to use this boy as a leader of Israel. Later, what happened? No, whatever they were thinking about Moses, that happened. He became the prominent person of Israel's history. So Moses became the prominent and important person of the history of Israel. The reason is his parents were having a clear picture about what he is going to be. And they were having a clear vision. They were a visionary parent. They were having a vision about their child, that this man, this child is going to be used by God to bring the people from the bondage of the Egypt to the promised land of Canaan. Hallelujah. So we should encourage them. We should encourage our children to be engaged in ministry, in Christian ministry. So that is our mission. That should be our mission. You know, we should encourage our children to be engaged always in Christian ministry. I know. We are, trying to involve our kids in different ministries. Okay, I know. I'm clear that we parents, of our eternal life, Church of God, we are trying to, engage every and involve every children of us into the different ministries. But moreover, we should tell them that if God gives you a job, if God gives you wealth, remember, you must spend a portion of that for God's ministry. This is amazing, you know. We are encouraging our children to be involved in different ministry. Our children are singing. Our children are preaching. They are, doing the gospel work. And they are reading the Bible. They are praying. Everything is okay. They are so active at the same time. If we have a vision about our children, that they are going to do the ministry of the Lord in a different way. If you have the vision about our children, they will become the ministers of God. Hallelujah. I believe that. You know, I pray for them. I pray for my children, and you have to pray for your children, that let them do the ministry of the Lord. Let them do the job. Let them do the job. Same time, they can work for the Lord in different capacities. Hallelujah. That's what we understand from the Bible, that they were praying for Moses and they were keeping him, inside the house for 3 months. And God used Moses in a tremendous way to lead the people of Israel from Egypt to Canaan. Hallelujah. So we have to, let us say to, let us encourage our children that remember, tell to our children that spend a portion of, wealth or the earning amount for the ministry of the Lord. You know, we have to say that the ultimate purpose of our earning, our job is not only for ourselves, or not only for our family, but for the ministry of the Lord. You know, for example, my kids, Alvin and Axa, you know, I used to tell them, and we used to tell them, you know, whatever you earn, or you may be getting a job, you may be getting a wealth, whatever it may be, you have to spend a portion of the amount of your earning for the ministry of the Lord. You know what happened? Because of that, when Alvin, got a small job here in Folsom itself, you know, after getting the first payment, he said, I'm going to send this amount to India for the ministry. We should have that passion about our children. So they are thinking about, at any cost, I need to do the ministry of the Lord in different way. So he was saying that, okay, I should send this amount to India because there are many people suffering. There are many servants of God, they are suffering. And there are many ministries. We have to help them. And both of them were, always that, okay, we should do something for the ministry in India. So I'm talking about my children, and you can also, encourage your children that you have to, increase those people, those children, that you can do, anything possible for the ministry of the Lord, whatever they are getting. Because, our children doesn't have that vision. Our children doesn't have that vision. They may be thinking that, okay, I'm working, I'm earning something, and I have the wealth, and I will use it for myself and for my family. No. Never think about that. Whatever we get, that should be, for the glory of God, and that should be for the ministry of the Lord. Hallelujah. So that's what I want to, make clear from that portion. And again, these parents of Moses, they had a vision of God's protection on their child. They have a vision about the God's protection on their child. For example, when you read Exodus chapter 2, verses 2 and 3, no time to read that portion, but it says, after 3 months, making an arrangement and putting the child by the river's brink. Without faith, it was not possible for a parent to do this. They were knowing that even though we put him at the riverside, God will protect him. Hallelujah. Keeping them in a particular place. And riverside, 3 months he was inside the house. Nobody was knowing that. But after that, putting the child, by the riverside or river spring. Okay, so without a faith, they cannot do that. They were clearly knowing that. Through faith, they were knowing that. The parents were knowing that. Even if we put him, at the riverside, God will protect him. So they were well aware about the protection of God on Moses the child. Hallelujah. So we should have that conviction, that faith, that our children will be kept and protected by God, because we are praying for them. Hallelujah. Because they are engaged in the ministry. Hallelujah. God will protect our children. Whatever happens, hallelujah, wherever they go, God will protect all our children. Hallelujah. And next portion I would like to speak from, that is, the impartation is one of the most important factors. The impartation is one of the most important factors. First of all, impartation of the courage of parents into the child. The impartation of the courage of parents into the child. So we were talking about the vision of a parent. So we have to, impart many things from us to our children. The first one, imparting our courage to our children. The faith enabled them to, when we think about Moses' parents, we understand the faith, enabled them to brave the anger of the king. Later we read that in Hebrews chapter 11 also. They were not afraid of the decree of the king. Parents' courage in Moses, I mean, life, we understand from Exodus chapter 5, verse 1, that again, he is standing in front of Pharaoh, the king of Egypt, and he is speaking very courageously. Boldly he is speaking to the Egyptian king Pharaoh. So we have to impart our courage to our children. We have to impart our courage to our children. Secondly, impartation of the blessing. So we have to impart the courage to the children, and also we have to impart the blessings upon the children. Hallelujah. You know, the sign of the parents must impart the blessings to our children and passing on the blessings to our children. So, you know, you have to understand one thing. Never curse them, rather bless them. You know, there are many parents, they usually curse the children, but never do that. We have to bless every time the children, and there will be a blessing for others. Hallelujah. You know, some of our children are weak in their studies. They are weak in intellect. They are weak in they may not be active for anything. They may be shy to interact with the other people. But remember, they have many potentials and they have many caliber. And the parents should be the best and first mentor and motivators to the children. Hallelujah. They may be weak. Doesn't matter. Hallelujah. If you pray for them and if you're blessing them, there will be a blessing. If you curse them, there will be a curse. Hallelujah. So remember that they have many potentials. They have many, talents in them. They have many caliber in them. And the parents are the best first mentor and motivators of the children. So let us give the instructions how to be successful in life. That is our responsibility. Okay, let us give the motivation for the children, instructions how to be successful in the future life. Hallelujah. So that's what we understand from that. It's true that they have sometimes we will say that we have a pastor, and they have a pastor, or they have their uncles or aunties and siblings in the house, and they have many friends and familiar people outside the society. But the parents are always the influential factor of the children. Most of the time, we don't remember that. The parents are the most influential factor of the children. There are many people. There is a pastor. There are many uncles and aunties or relatives or siblings and friends and familiar people. At the same time, we have to understand that parents are the always influential factor of the children. Hallelujah. So now we will come to the next main portion, that is responsibilities of a parent. Thank you, Jason, brother. You were talking about the responsibilities of a father, and we would like to look into that portion once again for 10 more minutes, maybe. Hallelujah. So let us come to that portion, and we already discussed about the first point, and Jason brother also told about that point, that is the chastisement of a disciplining. You know, we have a responsibility. Every parent, every father has a responsibility towards his children. Number one, chastisement or disciplining. So chastisement or disciplining is a sign of a vision on our child. If we have a vision on our child, we will chastise our children. If we have a vision about our children, we will discipline and we will punish sometimes our children. You know, the parent who has the vision about the child will surely chastise him. Otherwise, he will not do that. There are many Bible verses on this point. You know, when you read a book of Hebrews, chapter 12, book of Hebrews, chapter 12 gives us the importance of disciplining the child. That whole portion, we understand that maybe verses 1 through 11. It says about the importance of the disciplining the child. And again, Proverbs chapter 22 verse 6. Proverbs chapter 22 verse 6 says, train up a child in the way he should go. Even when he is old, he will not depart from it. It's a beautiful verse from Proverbs chapter 22 verse 6. So what is our responsibility? What is the responsibility of a parent? Training up the child in the way he should go. Even when he is old, he will not depart from it. Again, in Proverbs chapter 23, verses 13 through 15, Proverbs chapter 23, verses 13 through 15, it says that, do not withhold discipline from a child. If you punish them with a rod, they will not die. Punish them with a rod and save them from death. My son, if your heart is wise, then my heart will be glad indeed. It's a tremendous verse, you know. Now, do not withhold discipline from a child. If you punish them with a rod, they will not die. Is it right? If you punish them with a rod when they are in their childhood, we have to punish them. Okay, we have to instruct them. Okay, we have to give the corrections them. You know, when you punish with a rod, they will not die. They will not die. But punish them with a rod and save them from death. If you're punishing a child, you are saving their life from the death. So that's the reason I said that, we need chastisement, and every parents should punishment or correction or making them into the right way. And we have to think about how can we make them into the right way. So punishment is a sign of parents' intimate relationship with his children. Punishment is a parent's intimate relationship with the children. Hallelujah. That's what we understand from there. So disciplining is a sign of the father's love to his children. When you read Hebrews chapter 12, we understand that, okay, whenever we discipline the children, whenever we chastise the children, what we understand is a father's love. It's a father's love. If you love your children, you will discipline them. If you love your children, that means you are caring for your family. You are caring for your kids. And you have a vision about their future. Amen. The parents are always thinking about the future of the children because we are caring for them. We are providing everything for them. It's not simply we are providing everything for children. At the same time, we should have a careful attention on our children and about we should have a vision about their future. Hallelujah. Again, parents to be the best example to the children. Parents to be the best example to the children. Hallelujah. You know, they are always watching parents. The children, they are always watching parents. So we are supposed to be the best example for our children. Hallelujah. So they are watching us. And again, parents must be praying for your children. Hallelujah. This is our responsibility to pray for them. Always pray for them and let them be a great blessing for others. Hallelujah. Let them be used by the Lord in the coming days. Hallelujah. So this morning, I would request everyone to close your eyes in the presence of God. We are going to pray for a moment. Hallelujah. Dear Brother Reggie Jacob will be praying after this and after the message. Hallelujah. Let's all surrender our life in the presence of God. As we are, celebrating the Father's Day today. Hallelujah. What are the things that we can think about our responsibilities? Hallelujah. Are we praying for our children? Do we have the vision about our children? Do we have the spiritual vision about our children? Hallelujah. They are working. Maybe they are studying. They are doing their job. They are earning. But what is the ultimate purpose of giving them the job or the studies or the earning or the wealth? What is the ultimate purpose about that? It should be for the ministry of the Lord. It should be for the expansion of the kingdom of God. Hallelujah. If the parent is having the vision about the ministry of the Lord, that same vision will be imparted to the children. If a parent is vision about the future of the child, that person, that parent will always impart that blessings upon the children of God. Hallelujah. So this morning, let us all, think about that portion, that we should have a vision about our children. We should have a vision about our family. Hallelujah. God has called us and made us his children, not only to live in an ordinary life, but God has called every one person and God has given us a vision about our children. Hallelujah. As we are worshiping God, and as we are gathering together, and as we are celebrating the Father's Day, this is the wonderful message that I'm giving to you. That when you have a vision, you have to impart that vision to your children. Hallelujah. The parents of Moses, they were having the courage. And they were having a vision about Moses that he is going to be, glorifying the name of the Lord, and he is going to be used by God in a tremendous way. Hallelujah. As Moses' parents were having that vision about Moses the child, they were keeping him inside the house, without the knowledge of anybody for 3 months. It's not that easy to keep them or preserve him inside the house. But they did it because they were having that vision about that Moses. And they were well aware about Moses, that Moses is going to be useful vessel in the hands of God. Hallelujah. We should have that vision about our children. Hallelujah. Let them become maybe doctors. Let them become engineers. Let them become nurses. Whatever it may be. IT field or something. Anything. Let them become anything. Anyone. But we should have that vision, and we should impart that courage to our children. We should impart the blessings upon the children. Hallelujah. So that is our responsibility. Let us pray for them. Hallelujah. Let us pray for them. Let us bless them. Hallelujah. Do not curse your children. Always bless them, even though they are weak in different areas. Hallelujah. They may be weak in studies. They may not be active for anything. But they may not be, very, 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 very active for anything. They may be shy to speak to the people, but encourage them. Always pray for them, bless them, and strengthen them, and they will be becoming the mighty warriors for the name of the Lord in the coming days. Hallelujah. So this morning, let's all submit awesome the mighty hand of God, especially, hallelujah, let us pray for children. Hallelujah. Every fathers, you submit yourself in the mighty hand of God. Hallelujah. According to these verses, hallelujah. Oh Lord, let us pray the Lord. I need your presence, and I need your power. Hallelujah. I need your vision, and that to be imparted into me, and I will impart that vision into my children, oh God. Hallelujah. Let's submit ourselves in the mighty hand of God. Let's pray according to the word of God that we were hearing this morning. Hallelujah. I request brother Reggie to lead us in prayer now. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. Stotram, 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 stotram. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Naniyoda stotram. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Master. Hallelujah. Stotram, 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 stotram. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Glory, 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 glory. Thank you, Lord. Stotram, stotram. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Parishuddhanaya njangada devame srutasanaya nalla pidave. Vishwamanoharamaya divasathinte ഒരു വിശുദ്ധ ദിവസത്തിന്റെ പകൽക്കാലം കൂടി രാവിലെ കാലം ദൈവം മുതൽ ഇത്രത്തോളം അവിടുത്തെ സന്നിധാനം ഞങ്ങൾ ഒരുമിച്ചായിരിക്കാൻ ദൈവത്തെ സ്തുതിക്കുവാൻ രാവിലെ കാലം നല്ല പാട്ടുകൾ പാടി കർത്താവിന് മഹത്വ കരേറ്റുവാന്നൊക്കെ വേണം. പ്രൈസ് ദ ലോർഡ്. ഒരു വിശുദ്ധ ദിവസത്തിന് പകൽക്കാലം കൂടി അവിടെ ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് നൽകിയത് ഓർത്ത് ഞങ്ങൾ അങ്ങയോടെ ഞങ്ങളുടെ ആദിപിതാക്കന്മാർ ആരാധിച്ച കർത്താവിനെ ഒരുമിച്ച് പിന്നെയും ഹല്ലേലൂയ അങ്ങയുടെ നാമത്തിന് മഹത്വം കരേറ്റുവാൻ ഹല്ലേലൂയ അങ്ങ് ചെയ്ത ഉപകാരങ്ങൾക്ക് ഒത്തോണം നന്ദിയുള്ളവരായിരിക്കും എന്നൊക്കെ വേണം. അല്ലേ ഇന്ന് പകൽക്കാലം സന്നിധാനത്തിൽ പിന്നെയും ഞങ്ങളുടെ ഹൃദയങ്ങളെ പകരുവാൻ അങ്ങ് ചെയ്ത ഉപകാരങ്ങൾ നന്ദി പറയുവാൻ എന്നൊക്കെ വേണം. കർത്താവ് ഞങ്ങളൊരു അവസരം കൊണ്ട് നൽകി ഓർത്ത് നന്ദിയോടെ സ്തോത്രിച്ചിരുന്നു. കർത്താവേ രാവിലെ കാലം നല്ല പാട്ടുകൾ പാടിയെങ്കിൽ അങ്ങയുടെ നാമത്തിന് മഹത്വം കരേറ്റുവിനെ സഹായിച്ചല്ലോ. കർത്താവേ അവിടുത്തെ വചനത്തിൽ നിന്ന് ദൈവമേ ആ സങ്കീർത്തന ഭാഗത്തിൽ വായിപ്പാൻ കർത്താവ് ധ്യാനിപ്പാൻ എല്ലാം നീ ഞങ്ങളെ സഹായിച്ചല്ലോ. എന്മനമേ ഹോവയെ വാഴ്ത്തുക. എന്റെ സർവാന്തരംഗ വിശുദ്ധ നാമത്തെ വാഴ്ത്തുക. എന്മനമേ ഹോവയെ വാഴ്ത്തുക. ഉപകാരങ്ങൾ ഒന്നുപോലും മറന്നു പോകാതെ ഹല്ലേലൂയ ഹല്ലേലൂയ അങ്ങനെ ഞങ്ങളുടെ ദൈവമേ ഹല്ലേലൂയ അങ്ങനെ ഉപകാരങ്ങൾ ഒത്തിരി നന്ദിയുള്ള ആയിരിക്കും എന്നൊക്കെ വേണം. അവിടുന്ന് ഞങ്ങളുടെ അകൃത്യങ്ങളെല്ലാം മോചിപ്പിച്ച കർത്താവ് മോചിച്ച കർത്താവാണ്. ഹല്ലേലൂയ അവിടുന്ന് ഞങ്ങളെ നാശം ഞങ്ങൾ വീണ്ടും ദൈവത്തെ സ്തുതിക്കുവാൻ എന്റെ പകൽ കാലുവിനെ ഞങ്ങൾ സഹായിക്കുന്നു. ഓർത്ത് ഞങ്ങൾ നന്ദിയോടെ സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്ത കർത്താവേ കർത്താവിനുള്ള സമയം അവിടുത്തെ വചനത്തിൽ പിന്നെയും ശ്രീപാദ് സഹായിച്ചില്ല കർത്താവ്. കർത്താവേ. ദാസനോട് കേൾപ്പിച്ച നല്ല ഭജനങ്ങൾക്കായി ഞങ്ങൾ അങ്ങനെ സ്തുതിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ. ഹല്ലേലൂയ. ദൈവമായ കർത്താവേ, ഇന്ന് പകൽക്കാലം മാതാപിതാക്കളായ ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് ദൈവമേ ഞങ്ങളുടെ ഉത്തരവാദിത്തങ്ങളെ കുറിച്ച് കർത്താവേ, അതിൽ ഞങ്ങൾക്ക് തന്നിരിക്കുന്ന ദൈവമേ റെസ്പോൺസിബിലിറ്റിയെ കുറിച്ച് ഒരു പ്രാവശ്യം കൂടി ഞങ്ങൾ ചിന്തിപ്പാൻ, അത് ഞങ്ങൾ ഒന്നുകൂടെ ഓർപ്പിച്ചുണർത്തുവാൻ ഞങ്ങൾ സഹായിച്ചില്ല കർത്താവേ. ദൈവമേ, നിന്റെ വേലയ്ക്ക് വേണ്ടി, നിന്റെ നാമത്തിന്റെ മുഖത്തിന് വേണ്ടി നല്ല വിഷനുള്ളവരായിരിക്കും എന്നൊക്കെ ഞങ്ങളെ ഓരോരുത്തർ സഹായിക്കണമേ കർത്താവേ. അവിടുത്തെ വേലയെ കുറിച്ച് വലിയ കർത്താവേ ഹല്ലേലൂയ വലിയ ആത്മഭാരമുള്ളവരായിരിക്കും എന്നൊക്കെ പരിശുദ്ധാത്മാവ് ദിവസങ്ങളിൽ കർത്താവേ മാതാപിതാക്കൾ ഞങ്ങൾ ഓരോരുത്തർ സഹായിക്കണം ദൈവത്തോടെ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ. ഞങ്ങളുടെ കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങൾക്ക് ഞങ്ങൾ മാതൃകയുള്ളവരായിരിക്കും എന്നൊക്കെ കർത്താവേ ഹല്ലേലൂയ. ഞങ്ങൾ അറിഞ്ഞ ദൈവത്തെ, ഞങ്ങൾ സ്നേഹിക്കുന്ന, ഞങ്ങൾ സേവിച്ച ദൈവത്തെ, അതിനേക്കാൾ ഉപരിയായി കർത്താവ് ഞങ്ങൾ കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങൾ വിശ്വാസത്തിൽ വളരുന്നവരായിരിക്കും എന്നൊക്കെ ഞങ്ങളുടെ കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങളെ ഓരോരുത്തർ സഹായിക്കണം ദൈവത്തോടെ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ. ദൈവം അങ്ങയുടെ വേലയ്ക്ക് വേണ്ടി ദൈവമേ ഞങ്ങൾ കൊടുക്കുന്നവരായിരിക്കും എന്നൊക്കെ അങ്ങയുടെ വേലയ്ക്ക് വേണ്ടി ദൈവമേ ഇടിവിൽ നിന്ന് കരയുന്നവരായിരിക്കും എന്നൊക്കെ ഞങ്ങൾ ഏവരെയും സഹായിക്കണം ദൈവത്തോടെ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ. മാതാപിതാക്കളെ, ഓരോ പ്രിയപ്പെട്ടവരെയും അവിടുത്തെ കരങ്ങളെ ഏൽപ്പിച്ച് ഞങ്ങൾ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ. ഞങ്ങളുടെ കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങളുടെ ദൈവമേ, ആ ഞങ്ങളുടെ സമ്പത്ത് ഞങ്ങളുടെ കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങളാണ് കർത്താവേ. അല്ലേലൂയ. അവർ നിന്റെ സെനിൽ കാണപ്പെടുന്നവരായിരിച്ചറിഞ്ഞുകൊണ്ട് കർത്താവേ ജീവിതം അല്ലേലൂയ അത് പ്രകാരം കെട്ടിപ്പടുക്കുന്നവരായിരിക്കും എന്നൊക്കെ ഞങ്ങളെ എവരെയും സഹായിക്കണമേ എന്ന് മുതൽക്കാൽ ഞങ്ങൾ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. എല്ലാ പ്രിയപ്പെട്ടവരെയും പേരുവരായി പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. എല്ലാവരെയും സഹായിച്ചാണ് കർത്താവേ. കർത്താവേ, ഞങ്ങളുടെ പ്രിയപ്പെട്ട ഓരോരുത്തർ ജോലി കാര്യങ്ങളെല്ലാം അവിടെ സഹായിക്കണം ദൈവത്തോടെ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. ഈ പുതിയ ഒരു വർഷത്തിൽ ദൈവമേ അല്ലേ പുതിയ തീരുമാനത്തോടും പ്രതിഷ്ഠയോടും നിന്റെ നാമത്തിന്റെ മഹത്വത്തിന് ഞങ്ങളുടെ ആത്മീയ വർദ്ധന ഉദവത്തക്കണമായിരിക്കും എന്നൊക്കെ പരിശുദ്ധാത്മാവിന്റെ നിയന്ത്രണത്തിൽ എല്ലാമായിരുന്നു പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു കർത്താവേ. അല്ലേലൂയ. ബലപ്പെടുത്തി ഓർത്ത് സ്തോത്രം ചെയ്യുന്നു കർത്താവേ. നടത്തിയാട്ട് കർത്താവേ. ഞങ്ങളുടെ സന്ദേശ കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങളെ എല്ലാം ഓർത്ത് പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. ആമീൻ ആമീൻ. അവരെല്ലാവരും കർത്താവിന്റെ വചനത്തിൽ നിലനിന്ന് ആമീൻ വചനത്തിന്റെ കർത്താവേ ദൈവിക കാര്യത്തിൽ സമ്പന്നരായിരിക്കുന്ന കോണം ഞങ്ങളുടെ കുഞ്ഞുങ്ങളെല്ലാവരും സഹായിക്കണമെന്ന് ഞങ്ങൾ ദൈവത്തോടെ പ്രാർത്ഥിക്കുന്നു. ആമീൻ ആമീൻ ആമീൻ. അവിടുത്തെ കാര്യങ്ങൾ ഞങ്ങൾ പിന്നെ തന്നെ സമ്പൂർണ്ണമായി പിന്നെ താഴ്ത്തേൽപ്പിക്കുന്നു. അവിടുത്തെ പ്രാർത്ഥന പ്രേക്ഷകനായി സ്തോത്രം സ്തോത്രം സ്തോത്രം. ക്രിസ്തുയേശുവിന്റെ നാമത്തിൽ പിതാവേ,
ആമേൻ. പ്രൈസ് ഗോഡ്. ഹല്ലേലൂയ.